10th standard, math part 2nd, and lesson number 3 is a circle, and there is one theorem of angle between tangent and secant. There are 3 cases, 1, 2 and 3. So angle between tangent and secant, this is a tangent and this is a secant. So angle between tangent and secant means this angle is equal to the half of the intercepted arc intercepted by that angle. That is angle ABC is equal to half into measure of arc ADB. This is we have to prove. If an angle has its vertex on the circle, this angle ABC has its vertex B on the circle. Angle ABC has vertex B on the circle. Vertex B on the circle. Its one side touches the circle. Its one side, that is BC, touches the circle. BC touches the circle. And other intersect the circle in one more point. And other side, that is AB intersect circle at point A. AB intersect circle at point A. Then the measure of angle, that is angle ABC, is half of the measure of intercepted arc. Intercepted arc is here ADB. Therefore angle ABC is half of the measure of arc ADB. This is we have to prove here. Angle ABC is any angle whose vertex B lies on the circle with center M, and line BC is a tangent at point B, and line BA is a secant intersecting the circle at point A. Arc ADB is intercepted by angle ABC. Then we have to prove that angle ABC is equal to 1 upon 2 measure of arc ABC, ADC. Angle ABC is equal to 1 upon 2 measure of arc ADB. Angle ABC is equal to 1 upon 2 measure of arc ADB. Here also, angle ABC is equal to 1 upon 2 into measure of arc ADB. There lies 3 cases. Case 1, center M lies on the arm BA of angle ABC. Center M lies in the exterior of angle ABC, and center M lies in the interior of the angle ABC. Now the first case, center M lies on the arm BA of angle ABC. Now this angle MBC is 90 degree, because this MB is a radius and BC is a tangent. Angle between tangent and radius is 90 degree. Therefore this angle is 90 degree. It is called as a tangent theorem. Angle MBC is equal to 90 degree tangent theorem. Angle MBC means angle ABC. This angle is also 90 degree because A dash M dash B. Angle MBC is the same angle ABC. Therefore angle ABC is equal to 90 degree. Now let's see, this arc ADB is a semicircle, and measure of semicircle is 180 degree. Therefore measure of arc ADB is equal to 180 degree. This measure of arc ADB is 180 degree and angle ABC is 90 degree. Therefore this angle is half of this arc. Therefore angle ABC is equal to 1 upon 2 into measure of arc ADB. Angle ABC, this angle 90 degree, is equal to 1 upon 2 into measure of arc ADB. That is 1 upon 2 into 180 degree. Angle ABC is equal to 1 upon 2 measure of arc ADB. This is first case. Now the case number 2, center lies in the exterior of angle ABC. Now join MA and MB. MA is equal to MB, radii of the same circle. Therefore angle MBA is equal to angle MAB. Isosceles triangle theorem, these two angles are equal. Let angle MBA is equal to angle MAB is equal to X and angle ABC is equal to Y here. Now let's see in this triangle AMB, in this triangle sum of these three angles is 180 degree, that is angle AMB plus X is equal to 180 degree. Therefore angle AMB plus 2x is equal to 180 degree. Therefore this angle AMB is equal to 180 degree minus 2x. Now consider this angle, angle MBC is equal to angle MBA plus angle ABC, these two angles. Angle MBC is equal to X plus Y. Angle MBC is equal to X plus Y. But this angle is a 90 degree. Angle MBC is equal to 90 degree. Because this angle is angle between the tangent and radius. Therefore 90 degree is equal to X plus Y. From this value of X is 90 degree minus Y. Put this value in equation 1. That is angle AMB is equal to 180 degree minus 2 into value of X is 90 degree minus Y, that is 180 degree minus 180 degree plus 2Y. So 2Y is equal to angle AMB. So Y is equal to half of angle AMB. So Y is equal to ABC. So angle ABC is equal to half into angle AMB. But this angle is equal to this arc. This is central angle and this is minor arc. So central angle is equal to minor arc. Therefore angle AMB is equal to major of arc ADB. Major of arc ADB. Therefore angle ABC is equal to half of angle AMB and angle AMB is equal to major of arc ADB. Therefore angle ABC is equal to half into major of arc ADB. This is definition of major of minor arc. Now case number 3, center lies in the interior of angle ABC. This is angle ABC and center M lies in the interior of angle ABC. Now ray BE is opposite ray of BC. And now this angle AB is half of major of arc AFB. This is proved in case number 2. And therefore now this angle ABE is equal to 180 degree minus this angle. 180 degree minus angle ABC is equal to major of arc AFC. Now this major of arc AFC is also 360 degree minus this arc ADB. Therefore 360 degree minus major of arc ADB. Therefore 180 degree minus angle ABC is equal to 1 upon 2 into 360, that is 180 degree. 1 minus 1 upon 2 into this major of arc ADB. Now this 180 degree will get cancelled. What will remain is minus angle ABC is equal to minus 1 upon 2 major of arc ADB. Minus minus sign will get cancelled. Therefore angle ABC is equal to 1 upon 2 major of arc ADB. Thus theorem of angle between tangent and secant is proved. So angle between the tangent and secant, this is a tangent, this is a secant. So this angle between tangent and secant is half of the major of arc ADB, half of angle arc ADB. This angle is half of measure of arc ADB. This is called as a theorem of angle between tangent and secant. Theorem of internal division of chords. If two chords of a circle intersect each other in the interior of a circle, then the product of lengths of two segments of one chord is equal to the product of lengths of two segments of other chord. Here is a chord AB and CD are the chords of a circle with center P, and these chords intersect at point E, which is in the interior of the circle. Now join CA and BD, and we have to prove that the AE into EB is equal to CE into ED. Product of segments of one chord is equal to the product of segments of other chord. Now here are two triangles, triangle CAE and triangle BDE. In these two triangles, these two angles are congruent due to the vertically opposite angles, and this angle and this angle are congruent because they are angles inscribed in the same arc. For this angle, let's see the arc CAB. So this angle is inscribed in the arc CAB. And now let's see for this angle is also inscribed in the arc CAB. In other way, this angle, if we start from A and come to C, and on the other arm we start from A, come to B, therefore this angle intercept the arc BC. Similarly, this angle also intercept the arc BC. Therefore, these two angles are angles inscribed in the same arc. Therefore, for these two triangles, this angle is congruent to this angle. Angles inscribed in the same arc, and these two angles are vertically opposite angles. Therefore, these two triangles are similar by a test of similarity. Therefore, triangle CAE is similar triangle BDE. Take ratio of corresponding sides AE upon DE. AE upon DE is equal to CE upon BE. Corresponding sides of similar triangles, take cross multiplication, AE into BE is equal to CE into ED. Thus, theorem of internal division of chords is proved. Next theorem is a theorem of external division of chords. If secant containing the chords AB and CD intersect each other in the outside of a triangle circle. If secants containing AB and CD of a circle intersect outside the circle in point E, this is a secant containing the chord AB, and this is secant containing chord CD, and these two secants intersect outside of the circle in point E, then AE into EB is equal to CE into ED. This is, we have to prove, chords AB and CD of a circle intersect outside the circle in point E. Therefore, we have to prove AE into EB is equal to CE into ED. Draw segment DA and CB in triangle ADE. This triangle ADE and triangle CBE. In triangle ADE and triangle CBE, this angle is a common angle, and these two angles are congruent. Angles inscribed in the same arc. Now let's see for this angle, the arc in this arc from B to D. this arc inscribed, that is arc BA, D inscribe this angle, and for this angle also arc BAD inscribe this angle, therefore these angles are congruent. Or this angle, if we start from A to B and from A to D, we get arc BD. And for this angle, we also start from C to B and C to D, we get arc BD. Therefore, these two angles intersect the same arc BD. Therefore, these two angles are congruent. Therefore, in these two triangles, two angles are congruent. Therefore, these two triangles are similar by a test of similarity. Therefore, triangle AD is similar to triangle CBE. Take corresponding sides ratio AE upon CE is equal to ED upon ED upon EB. Cross multiplication AE into EB is equal to CE into AB. Thus, theorem of external division of chords is proved. Tangent secant segments theorem. AB is a secant passing through the point E. Point E is in the exterior of the circle and secant through point E intersect the circle at points A and B, and the tangent ET is a tangent. Tangent through point E touches the circle at point T, then EA into EB is equal to ET square. Tangent secant segments theorem. ET is a tangent, then EB is a secant, and AB is a segment. So this is called as a tangent secant segments theorem. Now here are two triangles, triangle EAT. This triangle EAT, this triangle EAT, and triangle ETB, ETB. In these two triangles, this angle is a common angle. In triangle EAT and ETB, angle E is a common angle, AET congruent, angle TEB common angle. Angle ETA, this angle ETA congruent angle EBD, this angle, these two angles are congruent, and the reason is the tangent secant theorem. This is a tangent and this is a secant. So, tangent secant theorem. Due to tangent secant theorem, this angle is equal to this angle. So, in these two triangles, this angle is a common and these two angles are congruent. Therefore, these two triangles are similar by a test of similarity. Therefore, we take a ratio EA upon ET is equal to ET upon EB. Cross multiplication EA into EB is equal to ET into ET, that is ET square. This is called as a tangent secant segments theorem.